தமிழில் பேசிட்டு தமிழ் டிரான்ஸ்லேட் பண்ணுங்க இன்ஷால்லாம்.
மதிப்புக்குரிய ஜாகிர் நாயக் அவர்களே, இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவையும் முகமது நபியும் அவர்களையும் இஸ்லாமியர்கள் நம்புகிறார்கள் என்பதை நான் அறிவேன். நானே வழியும் சத்தியும் ஜீவனமாக இருக்கிறேன் என்று, என்னையன்றி ஒருவனும் இறைவனிடத்தில் வர முடியாது என்று இயேசு இறுதியாக கூறியிருக்கும் போது, இயேசு கிறிஸ்துக்கு பின்வந்த முகமது நபி மூலமாக கொடுக்கப்பட்ட குரானை படித்து பின்பற்றியதன் மூலமாக இறைவனை எப்படி செல்ல முடியும்? இதற்கு தாங்கள் விளக்கம் தர வேண்டும். ஏனென்றால் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவே இறுதி என்று சொல்லப்பட்டிருக்கும் போது முகமது நபி எப்படி இறுதியாக ஆக முடியும் என்று கடவுள் சொல்லியிருக்க முடியும்? அதற்கு தாங்கள் விளக்கம் தர வேண்டும். மிக்க நன்றி.
Translate in English please.
When Jesus says that I am the way and truth, through me only you can reach my father, like that how can you reach Allah or God by following Quran which was revealed to Prophet Muhammad who is not giving any promise?
The brother assumes is a Christian. He posed the question that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, I am the way, the truth and the life. No man cometh unto my Father but through me. So if Jesus Christ has promised this, how can you reach to Allah? There's some addition.
மதிப்புக்குரிய ஜாகிர் நாயக் அவர்களே, நான் என்னுடைய பெயர் வந்து கிருஷ்ணன். நான் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவை விசுவாசித்து அவரை பின்பற்றி நடக்கிறேன்.
His name is Krishnan and he is following Jesus Christ's path of way.
So then if I said that, yes. Assume he's a Christian.
Yes. கிருஷ்ணன், இப்ப நீங்க கிருஷ்ணன், நீங்க ஹிந்துவா? இப்போ
இல்ல இல்ல, நான் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவை ஏற்றுக்கொண்டு அவரை ஃபாலோ பண்றேன்.
Okay, he took in the religion of Christianity. Yes, and I was following that. Yes. But his name is Krishnan. Yes,
that's what I assumed from his question, that I said that I assumed that the questioner is a Christian.
Yeah,
and he said that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said that I am the way, the truth and the life. The translation of that brother wasn't perfect. I'm doing the translation. I am the way, the truth and the life. No man cometh to my father but through me. So how do you come to God? Through Quran, and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam hasn't promised you anything. Brother, what you're quoting is the verse of the Bible. You haven't given the reference, I'll give reference. What you're quoting is Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 6. You haven't given the reference, I'm giving you reference. Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse number 6. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto my Father but through me. And many people assume that when they say this verse, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is claiming divinity. And many Christian missionaries, they quote this very often. You know, Jesus Christ said, peace be upon him, I am the way, the truth and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but through me. Now to know the context, whether is Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, claiming divinity, we have to go to verse number 1. When you read verse number 1 in the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse number 1, it says that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says that, why are you worried? If you believe in God, believe in me also. In my Father's house, there are many mansions, and I'm going there to prepare a place for you. If it was not so, I would have told you, I'm going there to prepare a place for you. And then he says, you know where I go. So one of the apostles says, no, we don't know the way. Then Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto my Father but through me. Now this statement means that if you want to understand Almighty God, you have to understand through the teachings of the messenger. So we do agree in this statement, what Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said is 100% perfect. What he meant was, if you want to reach God at his time, you had to go through his teachings. At the time of Moses, Moses was the way, the truth and the life. No man reached God but through the way Moses taught. At the time of Jesus Christ, we agree, he was the way, the truth and the life. No man came unto the Father but through him. But Jesus Christ also said earlier, in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14, I have many things to say unto you, but ye cannot understand now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that he hears shall he speak. Talking about another prophet to come, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So what he means to say, at the time of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Prophet Muhammad will be the way, the truth, and the life. No man come unto Almighty God but through Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So at the time of Jesus, I verily agree with you, we agree with the Bible, that Jesus was the messenger of God. He was the way to lead God. But he also said there's one more messenger to come. So today, anywhere in the world, whether you live in India or USA or Canada or Saudi Arabia, we have to follow the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So even according to your Bible, according to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, Gospel of John, chapter 16, verse 12 to 14, he says that another messenger is going to come. So leave aside the Quran. Your Bible is telling that. I have many things to say unto you, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, saying. I have many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that he shall speak, he shall glorify me. So leave aside Quran, even your Bible is saying that another messenger is going to come. He's Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he will guide you to all truth. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is today the way and the life. No man cometh unto Almighty God Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala but through the way of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's the reason when we say shahada, we say ashhadu allah ilaha illallah, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger and servant of Allah. Why? Because he is the way. And this revelation, the glorious Quran, is the last and final revelation of Almighty God. If you want to go to Almighty God, you have to follow his last and final revelation and the sayings of the last and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is given the Sahih Hadith. So if you follow Quran and the Sahih Hadith, inshallah, you will get salvation. Hope that answers the question.
Yes. Can I take the question from the sister's side, please? Is there any non-Muslim sister there?
Yes. Assalamu alaikum. I am Deepa. I am in Islam from last 3 years, and inshallah, I will be till my death.
Inshallah.
But main question is it compulsory for me to marry a Muslim guy or a Hindu guy? Since it is very hard task for me in the society to marry a Muslim guy.
Sister said, mashallah, she accepted Islam 3 years back, and she intends being on Islam till she dies. Mashallah, as you know, die not except in the state of Islam. Verse of the Quran, mashallah. But the question is that, is it compulsory that she should marry a Muslim boy? Is it compulsory? Yes, sister. Because Quran clearly mentions in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 221, that marry not an unbelieving woman, marry not a mushrika, an idolatress, until she believes. A believing woman, even if she may be a bondswoman, she is much better than an unbelieving woman, even if she allows you. That means in Quran, a man has to marry a Muslim, a believing woman. A believing woman who's a bond woman, she may be a servant, she may be ugly, she's far superior than an unbelieving woman, an idolatress, even if she allows you, even she may be the beauty queen, she may be the wealthiest woman in the world, a believing woman is far superior. And the verse continues, do not marry unbelieving man, do not marry a mushrik, do not marry an idolater, until he believes. A believing man, he may be a bondsman, he may be a servant, he may be ugly, he's far superior than an idolater, an unbelieving man, even if he allows you. He may be the most handsome man in the world, he may be the richest man in the world, but a believing man is far superior than an unbelieving man, than an idolater, even if he allows you. So sister, you have to marry a Muslim. You know why? If you have a vehicle, imagine a vehicle which has 4 tires, one tire of a cycle and the others of a truck. Do you think it will run? No. All the tires should be same. And if you know that Islam is the way that will get you salvation, and you have accepted Islam 3 years back, and you have promised you'll be on Islam till you die, why do you want your husband to go to hell? When we say to the spouse, we say better half. So even husband, if not better half, at least he's your worst half. But at least he's your half. So if you marry husband, if you are a good wife, don't you want your husband to go to Jannah? Don't you want your husband to go to paradise? So if you are a good lady, sister, but natural, you would even want your husband to go to Jannah. You may have some problems. I understand there will be difficulty in this world. The society may not accept you. But this life, sister, is for a small duration, average 50, 60 years. Some people die at the age of 10, some 20, some 50, some 90, some 100. Average 50, 60 years you're going to live. Even if you take the turmoil, the pain, for 50, 60 years, the next life is eternal, sister. As a businesswoman, it's a very good bargain. You have trouble, pain, difficulties, 50, 60 years. Next life, eternal, everything good. So sister, even if it's difficult for you, yet sister, my advice to you is, bear those difficulties. Marry a Muslim boy, even if he's not good, even if he's poor, even if he's ugly, he'll be much superior than the most handsome man or the most wealthiest man if he's an idolater, if he's a non-believer. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Jazakallah.